Hello students, this is the fifth video of organism and population, and topic of today is population growth, in which we will study processes changing population density and growth model, exponential growth model and logistic growth model. So let's start. Now, we know population density is total number of individuals present per unit area at a given time. So, total number of individuals present per unit area at a given time is population density. Four basic processes changes the population density. Let us look at that. Number one process that changes the population density is natality. Natality refers to number of births during a given period in a population. Second process changing the population density is mortality. Mortality refers to number of deaths during a given period in a population. Third factor is e-migration. E-migration means number of individual of same species that have come into the habitat from elsewhere. Or we can say number of individuals entering a country is e-migration. Fourth factor is a-migration. A-migration refers to number of individuals of a species that have left the habitat and have gone elsewhere. Meaning number of individuals leaving a country. Now, both natality and e-migration, it increases the population density. As you can see, because natality is number of birth, which would increase the population density, and e-migration is number of individuals entering a country. So both natality and e-migration would increase the population density, whereas mortality and emigration would decrease the population density, as mortality is number of death. Because of death, population density would decrease. And a migration is number of individuals leaving a country. So it will also decrease the population density. Now, from this diagram, we come to know that natality and e migration increases the population density, whereas a migration and mortality decreases the population density. So if n is the population density at time t, then population density at time t plus 1 would be n t plus 1 is equal to n t plus natality plus e-migration minus mortality plus a-migration. Here b refers to natality, I refers to e-migration, D refers to mortality and E refers to A migration. Now let us study what is exponential growth model. When resource availability is unlimited in a habitat, population grows in a rapid manner or population grows exponentially. So the first point to learn here is, in exponential growth model, resource availability is unlimited, due to which population grows very rapidly. For example, if we take fruit flies in a large cultural jar, and in that jar we put abundant food resource, so what would happen to the population of fruit flies? The population of that fruit fly would increase rapidly and it will show exponential growth. So, two points to learn in exponential growth is, the resource availability is unlimited in exponential growth, due to which population grows in a rapid manner. Now, let us study what is equation of exponential growth model. If population size is represented as N, per capita birth is represented as B, per capita death is represented as D, then increase or decrease in population size during time period t would be equal to dn by dt would be equal to per capita birth minus per capita death into n. We should remember that per capita birth minus per capita death is equal to r, where r is called intrinsic rate of natural increase. So if b minus d would be equal to r, then dn by dt would be equal to rn. Now, when population grows exponentially and we plot a graph between population density and time, we get a J-shaped graph. So in exponential growth model, we have a J-shaped graph. Now, let us look at other example of exponential growth model. Now, consider a forest in which there are hardly any carnivores. Since there are few carnivores in the forest, the population of herbivores would increase in an exponential manner. So, a forest in which there are hardly any carnivores, due to which population of herbivores increase rapidly, would be other example of exponential growth model. Now let us look at what is logistic growth model. We know that no population has unlimited resources. So no population in any country has unlimited resources. So there is always competition among individuals for resources. So eventually, fittest individual will survive. So a growth model in which due to limited resources, there is competition between the species, which lead to survival of the fittest, is called logistic growth model. So, 2 points to remember in logistic growth model is that in logistic growth model, there are limited number of resources. Due to limited number of resources, there is competition among the individuals, and due to which only the fittest individual survives. Now, the logistic growth graph is a S-shaped or sigmoid curve. As we can see here, if we plot a graph between population density and time t in logistic growth model, we have a S-shaped or sigmoid curved graph. Now, equation for logistic growth is dn by dt is equal to rn into k minus n by k. Here, k is the carrying capacity, that is maximum number of individuals environment can support, and r is the intrinsic rate of natural increase. We know that r is per capita birth minus per capita death rate. Now let us look at phases of logistic growth curve. We know that logistic growth curve is a sigmoid curve or S-shaped curve. It has 4 phases. The number 1 phase is lag phase. So here, this is the lag phase. In lag phase, population grows slowly. In lag phase, population grows slowly as there are shortage of individuals in reproductive age. So due to shortage of reproducing individuals, the population grows slowly in lag phase. Second phase is phase of acceleration. In phase of acceleration, birth rate exceeds the death rate. So birth rate is more and death rate is less. So this is the phase of acceleration. Third phase is phase of deceleration. In phase of deceleration, the death rate increases and birth rate decreases. So we have phase of deceleration. And last phase is phase of asymptote. Now in the phase of asymptote, birth rate and death rate are equal. So we have a constant line. So these are 4 phases of logistic growth curve. lag phase, phase of acceleration, phase of deceleration, and phase of asymptote. So if you have gained something from this video, please subscribe now to my channel Ramji Chopra, comment, like, and share.